Right here we have a 2020 Jeep Gladiator, and we're going to be bagging this thing, getting it ready hopefully for SEMA 2020 if everything goes as planned. Pretty much what we want to do is get rid of the front solid axle, put an independent front, and then put a dually axle in the rear, which is right there. And you know, take it from there, do the flares. We got my boy Harmeet in here. So here we're trying to get the center of the rim so that when we put the lower control arms and everything back on, we know exactly where the wheel needs to sit. This will ensure the turning and everything. So before we started, we had the Jeep on the floor. We made a marking on the flare, which is right there. Now we'll make a marking on that spring tower, and then we'll go from there. All right, so we got the center of where the rim was. When we had it on the ground, we did the markings there, and we did a marking on the floor. And now we got a marking on the frame that lines up. So this will tell us where the center of this rim sat. So when we do the lower control arm, we have some reference point to go based off.
We'll be right back.
right now we're just mocking up our lower cross member, you could call it, for the control arms. This is a Fat Fabs kit that we bought for the Dodge Rams. This is the right side for a Dodge Ram. This will go something like that. This for the upper control arms. And then we got the lower control arms here. So this is how the Jeep's looking after one day of progress. We took out the steering box, all the hydraulic lines going to it. There was an electronic pump here, we took that out as well. All these wires are free from the shock towers. This is everything that came out of the Jeep today. So we got the whole front axle assembly, the wheel liners, steering box. This is the electronic steering pump. This is new. Pretty cool. That's why the steering's so smooth. But yeah, this is a no need. Big thanks to Harmeet over here.